Hey, what is up, Lake City family? It's Bobby coming at you back at the grocery store in front of the Great Wall of Sweeteners because you guys have been asking for a sweetener video. What kind of sweeteners to use, which ones to avoid, which are keto friendly, which ones are great no sugar sweeteners. And man, there's a lot of options. I mean, I've never seen more sweeteners at the grocery store. So we're gonna talk about my favorite ones, but I thought the first thing we should talk about is my least favorite one, and that would be cane sugar. You guys gotta stay away from this stuff. And I don't care if it's cane sugar, sugar in the raw, turbinado sugar, organic cane sugar, sugar is the devil, you guys. We all know that it leads to obesity and diabetes, but it also is really bad for your gut, okay? It destroys the good gut bacteria and it helps the bad bacteria in your stomach. And what that does is it depresses your immune system and just keeps you in this perpetually kind of sick cycle. The average consumer has 19.5 teaspoons of sugar a day. So we need to start dropping that and either replacing that with sugar-free sweeteners or just lowering the sugar in general. The problem with eating sugar is that it feeds a lot of the diseases in your body. So if you're fighting off cancer or diabetes or any kind of arthritis, it feeds that and makes it worse. It's amazing what happens when you start dropping those out of your diet. You start to feel a lot better. Now, going from the bad end of the spectrum over to the really good one, let's check out these sweeteners. Now, monk fruit sweetener is my favorite low-carb sweetener alternative because the flavor is fantastic. It doesn't have any funky, bitter flavor, metallic flavor like a lot of other sweeteners like stevia. It is 300 times sweeter than sugar, so you have to be very careful while using it, which is why I like these sweetener blends. It's a one-to-one replacement for sugar in any recipe. This brand is fantastic. It's a blend here of erythritol, some chicory root, some Jerusalem artichoke, and some monk fruit. But it's such a nice blend that it tastes just like sugar. I use it one-to-one in baking. I use this for my homemade sugar-free keto ketchup recipe. It's delicious. And these guys are based in Chicago. It's a really nice couple. And they're on Amazon, so I'll put that link down below. Now, right below monk fruit would be stevia in terms of what I like. Stevia is great. It's a plant, as we know, from South America. It's a really sweet green leaf, and it actually is way sweeter than sugar. So all you need is 3/4 teaspoon of stevia to 2 teaspoons of sugar when you're using it. The thing is, they don't make stevia kind of blends, so it's tough to bake with this because if something calls for a cup of sugar, there's a lot of volume there. You can't quite do that with stevia. But the cool thing with stevia is that it comes in liquid form too. This is great because it's just pure stevia. It doesn't have any kind of fillers or anything. But both stevia and monk fruit are zero on the glycemic index, and they don't spike your blood sugar at all. Desi actually has a recipe for keto biscotti with chocolate, nuts, and citrus. I use stevia that is so darn tasty. I'll put that link down below also. Now, next up would be these guys, erythritol and xylitol. Now, these are sweeteners that I don't like. So erythritol, from a flavor standpoint, is not my favorite because it has this cooling effect on your tongue and it's not very pleasant. The interesting thing is that your body can't process or break down erythritol because it's a sugar alcohol, so it has no net carbs, calories, or sugar impact on your body at all. And xylitol is really popular in sugar-free gum, but I do not recommend using it for consumption because it wreaks havoc on your gut. It's terrible for your gut bacteria, for your intestines, and it can cause major digestion issues. The same with mannitol. Mannitol is pretty popular also. If you eat too much of that stuff, you're basically gonna poop your pants, so I really, really advise not using that. Then we come down here to a really nice sweetener that I like, coconut palm sugar. So this isn't keto, but it's a low glycemic natural sweetener that's actually loaded with tons of nutrients and vitamins that are really good for you. It's made from the sap of the coconut blossom. The sap comes out, they crystallize it into this, and this is really cool because here at Whole Foods, they have, we just saw the liquid version of that right here. This is coconut nectar. That's the liquid version of coconut sugar. Low glycemic, great flavor. It almost has like this caramely kind of flavor. And Desi actually has a killer recipe for carrot cake cupcakes that are gluten-free, dairy-free using coconut sugar. And she also has a berry crisp recipe that's gluten-free. I'll put those recipes down below. Because of the coconut sugar, it tastes so good. Now let's move on to honey. We've talked about this in previous haul videos. I want you guys to stay away from pasteurized honey. So even though the honey bear is super duper cute, every time it's pasteurized, it's heated to a point that makes it clear and also very pourable. and that's very pleasant for the consumer like us. The problem is it kills a ton of the nutrients and enzymes in here. So I would stay away from pasteurized honey, and I would buy only raw honey. Okay, raw honey has tons more nutrients and vitamins in there. It is a little more expensive, but also has a better flavor. Oh, actually, another reason to buy raw honey is there's a documentary right now on Netflix called Rotten, and they talk about the fact that China is importing a lot of honey to the market, and they're cutting it with rice syrup. And there's no way to know, because once it gets to the American shores, it's bottled as American honey. So it's another reason to buy local honey or raw honey. And the raw honey at Costco is by far the best price. It's way better than this. So definitely scoop that and look out for the fake honey coming from China. So I used to use a lot of agave because I really like the flavor. And yes, it's low on the glycemic index, but it turns out that agave nectar has a ton of fructose in it. Actually, almost the same amount of fructose that white refined sugar has. And that's really bad because over time, that could prevent your body from becoming sensitive to insulin and spike your blood sugars and make you have type 2 diabetes. So I would actually stay away from agave nectar right now. But right below it, maple syrup, right? The real deal. We're not talking about Aunt Jemima. We're talking about real Canadian Vermont maple syrup. Is low on the glycemic index. Also has a great flavor. It's also loaded with tons of nutrients and very nutritionally dense. And then there's something really cool down here, like blackstrap molasses. So molasses is very nutrient dense, low on the glycemic index too. And the blackstrap is the one you want to get because it's the third boil of the molasses. And on that third boil, you really get the nutrients condensed down into one bottle. So this is great. It's not keto friendly. And this is something that I tend to use from time to time. It's pomegranate molasses. The problem is this one, if you were to read, has a little bit of sugar in here. But the real deal ones, if you can get from like Middle Eastern or Arabic stores, like I got one in Israel, that is just pomegranate juice reduced down. That's absolutely delicious. And the flavor of that is fantastic. Put that over a little bit of hummus or some kind of Greek yogurt spread, so good. Now, what happens if you want to get your brown sugar fix for baking and you want a keto sweetener or a non-sugar based sweetener? Well, then you go into your cart of contraband. Who brings outside sweetener to the grocery store? Me, that's who. And this is what you want to get. This is sucrin brown sugar. It's a keto approved brown sugar substitute. It's erythritol based. It does have malt extract, so if you're gluten free, you can't have this. I'll put the Amazon link for this down below because I'll kind of show you right now. The texture of this stuff is amazing. It's soft and chewy, just like brown sugar would be. And I use this to make my sugar free keto barbecue sauce that is absolutely delicious. So definitely scoop some of this on Amazon because it's so good. Also reaching into my bag of goodies here are two sweeteners you want to avoid. They're so bad, they don't carry them at Whole Foods here. I had to bring them in. Splenda. Splenda is made with sucralose. Sucralose is a chemically made sugar that is really, really bad for you. There is a sugar brand at Walmart and everywhere, Heinz, sugar-free ketchup. And they use sucralose or Splenda to make it sugar-free. And Equal is made with aspartame, which is another really bad chemically made sugar, which I would highly recommend staying away from. But going back to the lighter side of things, they have some really cool sweeteners here at Whole Foods. They have date syrup, and if I go over here, they have date sugar. These are two really great low glycemic sugars that have a fantastic flavor, very complex, very kind of caramely and roasty and nutty. Date sugar is pricey. I mean, it's like $8 for a 1 pound bag. The problem with baking with date sugar is that it doesn't dissolve, so it kind of has that grainy texture. So I would use date syrup, or better yet, don't buy any of these. Use your own dates at home. So Desi's been using dates as sweeteners for her baking. You soak big fat medjool dates with the pits out in hot water and then blend it into desserts. She has a recipe for chocolate date brownies we dropped like the other week. Fantastic. And it's a great way to do an all natural sweetener that's low on the GI. I'll put that link down below in the description box. And there's some other really cool stuff here like apple sweetener. Low on the glycemic index, it's one ingredient, it's apple juice that are cooked down. I'm not sure how they get it to be clear, that's a mystery to me. What else? In addition to the maple syrup, over here they have pure maple sugar, which is really nice if you want to use it in the powdered form. It has that great flavor the liquid has. I'm going back to erythritol earlier. This is the main brand that erythritol is used for, Swerve. I would just avoid that because once again, it has a cooling effect on your tongue and I don't like this stuff. All right, you guys, that is it. We just covered this great wall of sweetener in great detail. I hope that helped you. In summary, monk fruit is my favorite no sugar sweetener. And the best part about it is that it's a one-to-one swap with cane sugar, AKA El Diablo. The problem is you gotta read the ingredients of what you're buying, because in any grocery store, if you buy stuff in the middle aisles of all the prepared foods, 90% of the time it's gonna have sugar in there, which is why you gotta start cooking your own food with ingredients that are whole, which is why I'm so excited for May 15th of next month for our keto meal prepping cookbook to drop. There's so many recipes in there that are gonna hook you up with clean eating recipes that actually taste good. All right, let's get out of here before we get kicked out. Plenty more grocery haul and ingredient haul videos coming soon, but Art and I will see you very soon. Until then, hashtag keep on cooking and mad love.